prayer. Lord Yeshua Messiah, thank you very much for this wonderful opportunity. Lord Yeshua Messiah, show for the loving kindness towards us. Lord, please bring many people to the sanctuary. Bless this sanctuary. Bless the Morning Star people. Lord, their cooking. Bless that food. Lord Yeshua Messiah, please bind the demon against of charity. Lord Yeshua Messiah, please be with that people. They are working hard there. Lord, remember my family also. Lord Yeshua Messiah, please be with them. Lord, bind that darkness, bind that evil spirits. Lord Yeshua Messiah, cover his spirit. Sprinkle your precious blood upon us. In the name of Lord Yeshua Messiah. Amen. My precious greetings in the name of Lord Yeshua Messiah to the viewers. I am going to explain about help. Adonai's help. Isaiah 31st chapter from 1st verse. Oh, to those going down to Egypt, expecting help, relying on horses, trusting in chariots because they have many, and in the strength of their cavalry man, but not looking to the Holy One of Israel, not consulting Adonai. Isaiah was the greatest prophet. He had seen so many visions, political visions, spiritual visions, so many. He walked with barefoot, he was naked. He revealed one thing, he advised something to the Israel people. People are going down to Egypt, expecting help. This is not the will of God. Don't expect help from Egypt. Egyptians are in darkness. Egyptians are pagan worshippers. Egyptians are witchcraft people. Egyptians are worshipping idols. Satanic worship is there. Don't rely on their horses. Don't trust them. Don't expect any kind of help from them. Nowadays, Christians should rely on God. Nowadays, Christians must get help from God and godly people. He said to Israelites, don't go to Egypt for help. I am saying to the women, don't go to the help with dark people. Don't expect help from the wicked people. Don't ask help sinners. And in the strength of their cavalry men, trusting in chariots, don't trust Egyptian chariots. Yes, Egyptian chariots are very strong, very powerful, very useful in battlefield. But don't trust the chariots. Don't trust your cars. Don't trust your money. Don't trust your silver. Don't trust your riches. Don't trust anything. Because they have many, don't think the number, don't see the number. Maybe the Egyptians are more than you. You are alone, you are in isolation. You have nobody, no mother, no father, no sister, no brother, no husband, no children, no family. You are alone in this world, maybe. Don't think you are alone. The congregation of God is with you. Angels are with you. The battalion is with you. And the strength of their cavalrymen. Yes, their soldiers may be strong. Their soldiers may be warriors. Their soldiers may be very good, expert in war. But don't believe, don't relay, don't give importance to their cavalrymen, to their soldiers, to the battlefield persons. Why? God said, they are humans. Not spirit, not God. Rely on God, expecting help from God. He said, but not looking to the Holy One of Israel, not consulting Adonai. There is two mistakes. There are two mistakes. One is, they are not looking to the Holy One of Israel. Next, they are not consulting Adonai. Two biggest mistakes. Being Christians, we must looking to the help from God. look unto him, expect help from him. Don't look unto the human beings. God will do miracles. Do God's work. Start God's work. God will continue that work with somebody. Consulting Adonai. You are consulting sorcerers. You are consulting witchcrafters. You are consulting idolaters. You are consulting palmistry people. You are consulting different witchcraft people. You are consulting worldly people. All your counselors are worldly people. God said, consult the prophets, consult the evangelists, consult the pastors, consult them. Because God appointed them. Elijah. Consult Elijah prophet. Israel's, they consulted prophets. So many major and minor prophets in Israel. So consult them. Now prophets are there, but rare. You go and ask the advice of the prophets, but you are not going, you are not visiting, you are not relying, you are not giving importance to your prophets, your pastors, you are neglecting pastors and evangelists. God said, don't do the same mistakes again. But he too is wise and can bring disaster, and he does not take back his words. He will rise against the house of evildoers and against the help of those who do wrong. Evildoers, house of evildoers. Some houses are place of Satan. They are doing evil things. They are mischieving people, misleading people. They are cheating people. They are saying we are Christians. Don't say like that. Don't behave like Gentiles. Their books are not mentioning about the cheating. But here God said, don't cheat the others. Now the Egyptians are man and not God, and their horses flesh and not spirit. Egyptians are men and not God. Remember, Egyptians are men, not God. The rich people are men, not God. The business people are men, not God. The politicians are men, not God. The landlords are men, not God. The influenced people are men, not God. Think that God is one. That God is Adonai. That God is Yeshua Mashiach. Yeshua Mashiach is the Hebrew name of Jesus Christ. Real name of Messiah. And your horse is flesh and not spirit. God said. He is saying about vehicles. People have luxury cars, luxury houses, duplex houses, multi-storied buildings. Don't look on it. Don't look. Don't stare. God said, don't think their hearts are powerful and it gives victory. Don't give respect. If the person is sinner, don't give respect, don't honor him. If the person is rich also, God doesn't like it. And not spirit. Yes, animal is animal. There is no spirit in the animal. There is no soul in the animal. We have soul. We have spirit. The Holy Spirit residing in our hearts. So God said, so likewise, Adonai Zevayah will descend to fight on Mount Zion on its hill. Yes, God is ready to fight on behalf of you. God is ready to fight with your disease. God is ready to fight with problems. God is ready to fight with your sickness. God is ready to fight with the virus in your body. He is ready. He is warrior. Are you ready? Are you inviting God? Are you welcoming God in your heart? Fight on Mount Zion, on its hill. Yes, he is descending to the Mount Zion. He is descending on the hill of Mount Zion. He is hill. He is rock. He is strong. He is a tower. He is a shield. He is a buckler. He is descend. Your prayer will descend God. Your prayer will get answer from God. Pray God. Pray ceaselessly. Like hovering birds, Adonai Zevayah will protect Yerushalayim. He said, like hovering birds. Adana is compared as a hovering bird. He is like a hovering bird. He spreads its wings. Messiah spreads his wings. He is like a bird. He is like an eagle. Don't worry for anything. Remove the bitterness from your heart. Remove that tension from your heart. Remove the stress from your heart. Pluck it out. Uproot that thing. Here, he said, he will fight on behalf of you. He is like a bird. A bird will care of its chicks. A bird will care of its nest. A bird will care of its eggs. A bird will nourish its chicks. A bird will sacrifice for its babies. God is also like that. He shed his blood for us. He sacrificed his life for us. Don't think he will not do anything. Don't underestimate God, the power of God. Adonai Jehovah will protect Jerusalem. Protection is important. The hen try to protect its chicks. The eagle will protect its chicks like that. God also try to protect you from the enemies, from the satanic people. If you are working in the office, don't worry about the men. If you are a woman, don't worry about the protection. God will protect you. If you are unmarried, don't worry about your protection. God will protect you. If you have no mother, don't worry. God will protect you. If you have no father, don't worry. God will protect you. Protector is there. Protector is in the heaven. He is the real protector. If you rely on anybody, if you believe anybody, what will happen? That person will cheat you. I know so many stories, so many incidents. Some widows, they scared. Who will protect me? Oh, this man will protect me. Oh, this married man will protect me. He is already married. He is already wife. He is already children. He will cheat women. Protection. They are men only, not God. Remember. Men are men only, not God. Remember. God will send help to you. He will protect you. He will guide you. He will counsel you. If anybody is blackmailing you, pray God. Say to your pastor or pastor wife or elders of the church or elders of your family. Say to the good people. Say to the righteous people. They will help you. God will send the helpers to you. So protection belongs to heaven. There are warriors are there. Millions of angels are there. Uncountable archangels are there. So many angels are there. They will help you. God will send you the angels to help you. Many soldiers are there in the heaven. He will rescue it. Yes, rescue operation. God will do rescue operation. Angels will do rescue operation. Yes, you are in deep ditch. You are in a deep well. You are in the floods. You are in the tsunami. You are in the tempest. You are in the cyclone. You are in the war. Nobody is there to help you, but God is there to help you. Remember that thing. Rescue operation. God will do the rescue operation. He will send his subordinates to help you. I am saying to all the girls. I am saying to the ladies especially. So many incidents in churches. So many incidents in the society. So many incidents in the offices. So many incidents in the fields. I am saying to all the women. Pray God. Take the help of God. He will send the rescue team. If the person is landlord, don't worry about that him. Don't bend. Don't believe. Don't trust. Their persons are ready to cheat. No landlord will not marry a coolie, a labor lady. There is no love. Only sexual perversion is there. So God said, rescue team. He will send rescue team to that fields. Your boss may be characterless. Don't worry. God will send the rescue operation team. The team never sleep, always ready. Ask God, come to the church, read the Bible, meditate the Bible. God will put a shield around you. God will put a protection around you. God will plant a fencing around you. Remember all these things. This is true. In sparing it, He will save it. Yes. Who is the Savior? Messiah is the Savior. Who will save your soul from the hell? Who will save your life from the robbers, from the stealers, from the cheaters? School children are going, 12 years, 8 years children, 13 years babies. Worst men are there to watch them, to tease them, to blackmail them, to take photos. Murdering. Teach your children. Cheaters are there, nets are there, hawks are there, eagles are there. But God said, I will save from the eagles. I will save from the murderers. I will save from the wicked people. I have a power, God said. Fast and pray. Nobody cannot do anything. Prayer is very powerful. So He is the Savior. He will save your soul. He will rescue you from that worst persons. Then Ashur will fall by a sword, not of mortals. A sword, not of humans, will devour him. He will flee before the sword. Yes. Ashur will fall by a sword, not of mortals. Sword, not of mortals. Sword, not of humans. This is important. Sword, not of mortals. There is a sword, special sword, royal sword. That sword never experienced defeat. A victorious sword in the heaven. Victorious sword in the hands of angels. Victorious sword in the hands of archangels. A sword will descend to rescue you, definitely. Seek for that sword. These knives, these weapons will not rescue you. They have bombs. They have pistols, they have sticks, they have modern weapons, but there is a weapon, a strong weapon, a real weapon, a good weapon, a rescue weapon in the heaven. Angels will bring that heaven. Other sword, He said the same thing. A sword not of humans will devour him. Yes. The sword will devour the enemy. The sword will devour the wicked people. The sword will devour the characterless people. The sword will devour the sinful people. Now corona, a punishment from God. I am not saying all the corona patients are sinners. The rulers are sinners. The ruling kings are sinners. So people will experience such kind of things. King David committed sin. So God punished Israelites. 70,000 people died in that period. They are innocent. 70,000 people are. Children are dying. Pregnant women are dying. So don't believe human beings' swords. Don't believe human beings' pistols. Don't believe human beings' war things. The heavenly sword devour all things. He will flee before the sword. Nobody cannot face the heavenly sword. David is very powerful. God is with King David. The shepherdic boy became king. God helped to King David in so many battles. He conquered all the battles. He became winner by the grace of Adonai. God sent His heavenly troop to help him, to rescue him. You know, nothing is impossible to God. They will flee from that sword. Yes, Nothing can stop that sword. It will wound, it will pierce, it will kill, it will murder. God said the same thing. And his young men will put to forced labor. Forced labor. Yes, many children are working child labor. Our constitution prohibited that thing. Child labor is a crime, but millions of children are working in factories. Millions of children working in brick factories. Millions of children working in furnaces. Millions of children working in bangle factories. Many children working in hotels. 15 years boys, 40 years boys. It is a curse to that hotel. It is a curse to that house. It is a curse to that family. Don't force the children to work. It is against the law of God. They live happily. They must enjoy their life. In vegetable shops, shopping malls, fields, cattle work, fowls work. Their children are very happy. Their children are like road roamers, roaming like. They are not eating, they are not studying, simply eating and enjoying. But the labor class people, the children are working. God won't spare all these things. Many crores of child labor in India. Please pray for the children. Rescue the children. Help the children. Children are begging in the streets. Help them. Whatever you can. Helping it is very important. His rock out of terror will pass away, and his panicked officers will desert the standard. His rock out of terror will pass away, and his panicked officers will desert the standard. Panicked officers. Now, panic in officers' life. Panicked officers are there. The police department, or the administration department, the ministers, the cabinet, the parliament, the church, the pastors. Panicked officers. They are panicked because why God said all these things? They are panicked. They can't do anything now. Corona is spreading, rapidly spreading. Every street, every village, every city, every state, corona patients are there. COVID-19 patients are there. Officers are panicked because nothing in their hands. No medicine, no vaccine, no tablets, no injections. They are panicked. But many doctors are cheating, hospitals are cheating. There is no medicine to COVID-19. How did they pay? How did they force the people to pay the bills? Lakhs? 1 lakh, 2 lakh, 50,000, 7 lakhs? Is it good? Curse. They are already patients. They are affected. Virus is in their body, tension in their body, fear is in their body. But you are collecting money from them. You are robbing the patients. It is a sin. Being a doctor, do good to the people. Do good to the society. Missionaries have established so many hospitals, churches and schools in India. They are not that missionary doctors. They help to the poor. There is no race. There is no caste. There is no gender feeling. They help everybody. No fees at that time. Freely they are working. But how many doctors are working freely? At least 5% people. You could do help at least 5 or 10% people in your life. You are accountable to God. God is a real judge. He will judge you one day because of all your wickedness. Most of the private hospitals, they are extracting, they are sucking the blood of the patients. I am saying to all the patients, remember God, pray God, rely on God, approach a good doctor, approach a good hospital, not a commercial hospitals. People are suffering, no humanity in their life. So says Adonai, whose fire is in Zion, whose furnace is in Jerusalem. Yes, fire is in Zion. You are a fire. Fire in your body, fire in your spirit, fire in your soul, fire in your house, fire in the church. The Holy Spirit is a real fire. Invite that Holy Spirit. If the Spirit is in residing in your heart, Satan will not do anything. Fire around us. Don't fear. So many corona patients are healed. So many corona patients are prayed. God healed them. God rescued them. Please call me if you are a corona patient. If you are a COVID-19 patient, I will pray for you over the telephone. My phone number is 701-136-71507. Again saying 701-136-71507. Malla cheptanu. My phone number is 701-136-71507. Phone chain number. Call me to this number. I will pray for you. Believe God. Trust God. Don't challenge God. Don't call such kind of people. Furnace is in Jerusalem. Yes. God is processed us. God is cleaning us. Jerusalem is the holy city. Jerusalem is the best city. Jerusalem is the blessed city. Jerusalem is the powerful city. You will become in Jerusalem. Let us see. Isaiah 30 chapter, first verse. Oh, to the rebellious children, says Adonai, to make plans, but the plans are not mine. They develop alliances, but not from my spirit, in order to pile sin upon sin. Yes, rebellious children. God is calling, oh, rebellious children. Oh, to the rebellious children. Don't be rebellious. Absalom is rebellious person. Amnon is rebellious person. Isabel, rebellious person. God said, don't be rebellious. Don't rebellious to God. Don't rebellious to the prophet. Don't rebellious to your family members. Obedient. Surrender yourself. A wife should be obedient to the husband. A husband should love his wife. Don't be rebellious. Don't be rebellious against the government. If the government is good, doing good to the poor, don't be rebellious. They make plans. Yes, God has a plan. His plan is perfect plan. But here, satanic plans are there. Which plan? Satanic plans. Your plans are not the plans of God. Your plans are not in the heart of God. His plan is different. Your plan is different. I hear so many bad and sorrowful incidents. In offices, men have plans to trap women. So women have plans to trap men, to trap especially rich men. Plans are not mine. Yes, that plan is not belongs to God. Moses have some plans. Joshua also has some plans. He had very good plan. But your plan is a corrupted plan. You're watching women, harassing women, blackmailing women, teasing women, spoiling the lives of women. That is your plan. Nowadays, these things are going on many. They can't tell to anybody because they're already blackmailed. Criminal-minded people. Criminals are doing all these things. Punishment for the criminals. And they develop alliances, but not from a spirit. They develop alliances, Yes. You should develop alliance with God, with the Holy Spirit, with the holy people, with the righteous people, with the church, good church. But you make alliance. You develop alliance with the wicked people. Absalom also have done the same thing. Rehoboam also has done the same thing. Rebellious nature. But not from a spirit. Yes. God has a plan. Ask the plan. Prophet has a plan. Ask the plan. They will reveal that plan about your future and life. You are in the grip of somebody. You are in the hands of somebody. You are trapped by somebody. Your life is always in snares, full of traps. Ask God. He will release you from the traps. So God said, they go down to Egypt, but don't consult me. Yes. You are consulting different people. You are not consulting your parents. You are not consulting your teachers. You are not consulting your lecturers. You are not consulting your principal. You are not consulting good people. You are consulting bad people. They are always watching TVs and movies, serials. They will give a different idea. That idea will spoil your life. Rehoboam also had taken different opinions from the wicked youngsters. They spoiled his future. He lost his kingdom finally. Many tribes he lost. Seeking refuge in Pharaoh's protection. Seeking shelter in Egypt's shadows. Yes. Seeking refuge. God is our shelter. Seek refuge at the feet of God. Don't at the feet of people. Pharaoh's protection is waste. Seeking shelter in Egypt's shadow. Egypt's shadow. You are living in somebody's shadow. You are living in other shadow. You are living in rich people's shadow. You are living in serpent's shadow. He is serpent. His shadow is a poisonous shadow. His shadow is a dangerous shadow. His shadow is a worst shadow. Some woman said to me, he will be our protector. We will be safe under his shadow. I am saying you will not be safe under his shadow, because he is not your husband. He is husband to some other woman. Why are you doing all these things? Nonsense. Shelter. I am saying only husband will provide shelter, clothes, food and everything to the wife in a right way. Don't rely on other men. They will not sustain you. They will not protect you. They will not rescue you. They will not feed you. Many women, they are working. They are protecting themselves. They are feeding themselves. But they are living under the shadow of other men. But Pharaoh's protection will bring you shame. Yes. Girls, they are not caring their parents. They are caring boyfriends. Young boys also, they are not caring their parents. They are caring girlfriends. They are going to prosecute somebody. I am saying about that character's persons only. They will get shame. God said. It will bring shame. Your character will bring shame. Your decision will bring shame. Your idea will bring shame. He left you one day. So many women in many countries also, when they are pregnant, they left them. When they have children, they left them. Because there is no marriage between them. There is no bondage between them. There is no holiness between them. There is no marriage in the church. Simply they have decided, they have a plan. And living together. Live in relationships. Very dangerous, very poisonous. No respect, no honor. Finally, you will receive shame. He he will leave you one day. Sheldon is if shadow will lead to disgrace. Yes, don't take shelter. It will lead to disgrace. God said very clearly, no honor in your life. Leave honorably. Leave. Lead your life respectfully. Don't live like an animal. Don't live like a pig. Don't live like a waste person. Meaning should be important. Honor should be important. So many nets around you. So many wicked people. You cannot trace it. Listen the elder's decision. Listen the pastor's words. Listen the biblical words. Sixth verse. A prophecy about the animals in the Negev. In the land of trouble and anguish, of lionesses and roaring lions, of vipers and poisonous flying serpents, they carry their riches on donkeys' backs and their treasures on camels' humps to people who will not help them. To people who will not help them. Yes, people are journeying to one land that people will not help them. But in which way they are going, he said, treasures on camel's humps. Treasures on camel's humps. Yes. Teenagers, ladies, they believe their lovers, their boyfriends. So they carry the treasure in their house. They carry their gold from their house. They carry the silver from their house. They carry all things. They carry the diamonds. They carry the cash. And elope with them. And flee with them and run with them and they try to live with them. 3 days, 3 months after that, the money, or 2 years, the money will become a vapor. No money in their hands. At that moment, other boyfriend or that lover will left that lady. So this person will commit suicide. I am saying to that ladies, don't commit suicides. Whatever happened, happened. Forget about it. Leave it. Start a new life. Life is there. Your life is not your boyfriend. Your life is not your husband. Your life is not your lover. Your life is with God. Your life is with Bible. Your life is with the worship. If you are cheated, death is not a solution. Suicide is not the permanent solution. Don't commit suicide. Stop it. Stop that thing. God will do miracle. He will change your life. He will transform your life. He will never neglect you. He will embrace you. He will kiss you. He will hug you. He will give you a new life. He will set your life. Remember, carry their riches and donkeys' backs. Yes, they simply sat behind the boyfriend's bikes or in their cars. They're enjoying. Remember, poisonous smiles, poisonous heart, poisonous looks. Save your life. So these people are going to land of trouble and anguish, of lionesses and roaring lions. Land of trouble. You will face trouble if you go with that man. If you go with that woman. If you go with that prostitute. He will take all your cash. He will take all your gold. He will take all your salary. She will left finally. Prostitute is for money. She is doing that prostitution for money. Don't approach her. Don't believe her. Don't trust her. Believe your wife. Rely on her shoulder. God has given real helpmate to you. Poisonous flying serpents. Yes. Vipers and poisonous flying serpents. Israelites journeyed in this Mount Sinai area. The Sinai desert. Negev desert. serpents are there, flying serpents are there, poisonous flying serpents under the feet of Israelites. But God shut their mouths. Yes, God will shut that boyfriend mouth. God will shut that lover mouth. God will shut that cheating person mouth. Remember all these things. He may be like a poisonous flying serpents. Yes, some men are like poisonous flying serpents. They are blackmailing with letters, photos and everything. Let them blackmail. Save your life. Pray God. Try to overcome the situation. You are not overcoming the situations. One married woman came to this church. She is married. But she is blackmailed by local criminal. That local criminal is handling her. She has two children. She is in his pangs of devil. That person is also married. He left his wife. She left her husband. What is this? Is it marriage or prostitution? Marriage is honorable in all. Marriage is good. Come from the land of trouble. Come from the land of anguish. Come from the poisonous flying serpents. The sacred seers don't see. To those who have visions, don't tell us the visions you have as they really are, but flatter us, fabricate illusions. They say to the seers, don't see. They give warnings to the pastors. They are giving warning to the evangelists. They are warning to their parents. They are saying, don't see the visions. Don't tell the visions. Don't reveal the secrets of God. Don't advise us. We will not follow your precepts. We will not follow your advices. We will follow rubbish. We will journey to land of trouble and anguish. Stop your journey right now. Fabricate illusions and but flatter us. Yes. They expected good visions. They expected sweet words. They expected very kind words. Fabricated words. He said that fabricate illusions. God said, don't do. False prophets will do all these things because they want money, they want their 10%, they want their offerings. Don't take the 10% from such kind of characterless people. Don't take the offerings from such kind of wicked people. Send them from the churches. Eliminate from the churches. Because they are spoiling other women's lives. Church is a place of holiness. Returning and resting is what will save you. Calmness and confidence will make you strong. But you want none of this. Return unto God. Be silent. God will save you. Be silent. Don't worry. Don't feel tension. Don't be nervous. He is a redeemer. He is a rescuer. Calmness and confidence. Now you have no confidence. Improve your self-confidence. Demonic spirits will devour the confidence. Be confident. You are educated. You have character. You have prayerful life. So God said, what did He say? Be confident. Calmness is important. Be calm in the church. Don't be arrogant in the church. Don't be serious in the church. Don't be naughty in the church. Change your behavior, change your attitude, change your mindset. Here God said, be silent. Calmness will save you. Confidence will save you. Now people lost confidence in lockdown. Now people lost confidence about their health. People lost confidence about their future. That is a demonic thing. God said, be confident. Deborah is confident. Esther is confident. Ruth is confident. That confidence is very important. Yet Adonai is just waiting to show you favor. Yes, he will show you favor. Nobody will show you favor. God showed favor in Esther's life. God showed favor in Ruth's life. God showed favor in prophets' lives. He will show the favor. You are very favorful to God. You are a chosen rose. You are a good in the sight of God. He is waiting to help you. He will have pity on you from on high. Yes, pity. Not a drama, not an action. Real pity. It is from the heaven. God is pity on you. God is pity on your family. God is pity on your education. God is pity on your soul. He is very merciful, very kind. God said all these things. Then thou, Adonai, may give you but bread and water and not very much of that. Bread and water. Water. But he will give you a very different bread and water to the wicked people. Judgment is going on. Isaiah 28 chapter 19 verse. The humble will again rejoice in Adonai, and the poor exult in the Holy One of Israel. The word of saying, the scripture is saying, the humble will again rejoice in Adonai. Be humble before the prophet, before the pastor, before your master, before your lecturer, before your elder, before your boss, before an official. Be humble. Surrender yourself. Be humble. Rejoice in Adonai. Yes, there is a joy is waiting for you. Happiness is waiting for you. God is saying all these things. And the poor exult Holy One of Israel. God consider the poor people petition. He will answer it. He said, I am the real judge. I am the real lawyer. Lawyer will not do justice, judge will not do justice. He can't understand. You're going to the court from 10 years or 7 years or 18 years. You may not get justice brought, but you will get justice from the divine judge. He is the real judge, redeemer, savior. Remember, he will save you, he will rescue you, he will protect you. What else more than that? Believe God. Let us pray. Lord Yeshua, I am praying for the people, those who are listening the word of God. I am praying for the women. I am praying for the widows. I am praying for the teenage girls. I am praying for all the women. Lord, protect the women. Lord, rescue the women. Lord, power a spirit upon them also. Touch them right now. Yeshua Messiah, do good in their lives. Save them from the traps. Save them from the pit. Save them from the wicked people. Save them from the cheaters. Lord, Yeshua, sprinkle your precious blood upon them. Raise them from the pain and suffering strife also. Lord, Yeshua Messiah, bring them into their sanctuary. Lord, put them under their wings. In the name of Lord Yeshua Messiah. Amen. Amen. Thank you.